Today, I'd like to talk about embedded GUI again. This is a topic that I personally really like. Please wait a moment about this. Building a user interface in an embedded environment, especially in a very low power microcontroller such as Arduino and ESP32, was not an easy task. However, a GUI toolkit called LVGL made it possible to create a very nice interface. This allowed us to create more and different types of IoT systems at the not only industry level, but also the individual level, and made various tries possible. Personally, I really like LVGL, and it seems to empower me to draw on the screen what I want to express. The new GUI toolkit introduced in this video is Slint. This is also a GUI tool for creating a native user interface. Its features is that you can create GUIs for all devices such as mobile and PC as well as embedded ones. If you want to deliver the same feelings to users on all platforms, you can create a single UI code that can be used on all platforms. And Slint files can be compiled into Rust, C++, and JavaScript. The Slint component for ESP-IDF provides the C++ version of Slint. This is a demo version running on ESP32-S3-Box-3. This time, let's see it in action on the mobile side. This is not exactly the same code. However, because of most of the components are reused, you can see very similar screens and widgets. You can also see that the basic program workflow behaves the same. If you visit the Slint website, you can see that they say Slint can replace not only LVGL, but also the UI part of mobile applications such as Flutter. Personally, I don't think it can really replace Flutter since it is already capable of creating great applications for Android and iPhone. However, it seems like it could be LVGL's biggest enemy. I guess I will have to try harder for more details. This video is just a preview. I will try a simple project with Slint and then come back to talk about the pros and cons. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.